You ready, people? Let's do this.
I'm inside the ventilation shaft, Shep. It's hot in here, but it's clear.
Second team, are you in position?
In position. Meet you on the other side of those doors.
All right, so we have the other team kind of running parallel with us, and Kasumi in between in a ventilation shaft. Our job here is to fight through these hordes of collectors and try to keep her from getting burned to death while she's essentially unlocking all the security doors for us along the way. Something like that. This being their base, of course, there's going to be no shortage of these guys here, right? I don't think Kasumi's little timer starts counting down until we hit that first switch, and then we're gonna need to be kind of fast. I've never been really good with timed missions, personally.
Something's blocking the pipe. Gotta find a way through that gate.
There, over by the ventilation shaft. That valve should open the gate.
You can see her up there, crawling through the ventilation duct.
Heading through the gate now.
I will direct this personally.
I've got it. Your target.
Stop shooting me!
Assuming control. The forces of the universe bend to me.
Damn it,
that is really a key to this on Insanity, is the ability to one-shot these collectors with headshots. Even when they have some resistances up.
Do you feel this?
Shep, it's getting hot in here.
Damn! Up there!
Jacob here. Ran into some headroom. I'm behind schedule, but we'll try to catch up at the rendezvous point.
There we go.
This I'm on it. You.
Fireballs can knock you out of cover. Yep. When you're getting shot at by several other collectors at the same time, that's usually deadly. In fact, I would say that in and of itself has killed me more times than anything else. A stupid fireball knocking me out of cover. Not doing any damage in and of itself, but opening me up to take fire while I'm kind of stunlocked. Actually, I think before hitting that fourth valve, I think you can come clear out a couple of these guys, then go back and let her through. Give a little extra time. I don't think we'll have a problem here, but
not a problem.
That is another way to do this. At some point here, I think I'm going to turn on autosave, because when we get towards the end of this, I don't think it's going to give me much of a chance to manually save. To avoid redoing entire sections of this if I don't have to.
Damn it, I'm blocked again.
Okay, so it took her a little while to get up to that next one. I see it. I see the switch right there.
Assuming control.
Of course we have a mob come in. Of course we do. Oh, no, no, no. That might cost me. Poor Kasumi's in there burning up.
Shepard,
I know you are.
You bet.
Nice.
You
nice.
Cannot resist.
You know what? Screw that guy.
If I die, I'm haunting you, Shepard.
Nice.
I'm on it.
This is what you face.
You bet.
Frick fireballs, man.
They're as good as.
Suck on that.
Easy enough.
Wow, really?
Looks like another one of those things in the way. Gotta help me out again, Shep.
I know you.
You know what? Do that the old-fashioned way. There you go. Y'all going? You weren't running a minute ago, bitches. Oh wow. Take that. Okay, that's a switch right there, isn't it? Being protected by a dude with a special weapon. One more.
Moving on. Should be near the end now.
Not a problem here.
I'm not sure if I can just fast track this. I think if I go hit that last switch, if I cloak out, it probably ends this. Probably. But we'll go ahead and kill these guys just because they're here.
I must tear you apart, Shepard.
One more valve to go, Shep.
I know. I'll be there in a second. You got plenty of time.
Engaging top.
Oh, I thought you did. It's like they brought back up this time. Fireballs, man. Annoying. Take that. Your face.
It's too hot. I'm burning up. Hurry, open the valve.
Yeah, I think that last switch triggers a cutscene regardless.
Come in. Look out. Second floor. We're in position. We need this door open now.
I knew you wouldn't let me down. Shepard, you need to see this.
Pods and a lot of tubes running the length of the ship.
Looks like one of the missing colonists.
There's more, over here.
God. She's still alive!
That's Kelly. Alright, so this is our crew. Dr. Chakwas?
Dr. Chakwas, are you okay? Shepard, you came for us. No one gets left behind.
Thank God you got here in time. A few more seconds and I don't even want to think about it.
The colonists were processed. Those swarms of little robots, they melted their bodies into gray liquid and pumped it through these tubes.
Why are they doing this? What are they doing with our genetic material?
I don't know. I'm just glad you got here before it happened to us.
So are we. But we still have a job to do. We've done well so far. Let's hope we can finish the job.
Joker, can you get a fix on our position?
Roger that, Commander. All those tubes lead into the main control room right above you. The route is blocked by a security door, but there's another chamber that runs parallel to the one you're in.
I cannot recommend that. Thermal emissions suggest the chamber is overrun with seeker swarms. Morden's countermeasure cannot protect you against so many at once.
What about biotics? Could we create a biotic field to keep them from getting near us?
Yes, I think it may be possible. I wouldn't be able to protect everyone, but we might be able to get a small team through if they stayed close.
I could do it too. In theory, any biotic could handle it. Shepard, who do you want to maintain the field?
Samara, she's a beast.
Samara and I will take a small team through the Seeker Swarms. The rest of you provide a diversion by going through the main passage. We'll open the security doors from the other side and meet you there.
Who should lead the diversion team?
Well, Jacob seems to be doing good so far.
I'll keep the defenders busy while you slip in the back.
What about me and the rest of the crew, Shepard? We're in no shape to fight.
Commander, we have enough systems back online to do a pickup, but we need to land back from your position.
We can't afford to go back, Shepard. Not now.
You'll never make it without help. I'll send someone with you.
No, I think I'm gonna keep him for later. Garrus can lead, sure.
Joker, send me the location of the landing zone. We'll meet you.
We've all got our assignments. Let's move out.
All right, we're going to be the biotic squad this time. Smart keeping the shield up, and Jack and Miranda throwing warps and stuff everywhere.
Try to stay close, Commander.
Shockwaves. You get a hell of a Paragon score right there for escorting the people back. I don't plan on losing anybody. No crew members, no team members, nobody.
Are interfering with radio contact.
Yeah, those stupid collectors have done enough. Okay, I think I can save between each little phase of this here. We're gonna have to run through a couple gauntlets.
Let's go, Commander.
This is like a small arena battle because you can't really... You can leave the barrier for a second. Those swarms like eat your shields almost instantly. Well, they can just straight out kill you.
Change weapons.
Right away.
Incoming.
You've been spotted.
It'd be nice if this barrier we have up could hold off bullets.
Moving to point.
From this position. Tell me. Got him. That was kind of a waste of a round right there, wasn't it?
I know you feel this.
Somebody kill this guy, would you? This isn't so bad as long as you can keep him down there somewhere. Oh, bitch keeps knocking me out of cover. Yeah, that's annoying. I'm serious. That is annoying. Tell you what, his full bar of armor, though, I'm one-shotting that. That shit is just gone. I guess it's his barrier that was really, really the tough one. In that case, it'd probably be good to have warp ammo. It would. Could probably have assigned Jack to fully upgraded warp ammo and then given it to the rest of the team. Probably help a bit. I seriously doubt I could one-shot that thing through a full barrier regardless. But, oh, nice! Do not want to get caught out there in the secret swarms. No, no, no. Got this barrier up for a reason, right? Okay, now this is nasty. A lot less cover to deal with.
Let me know when you're ready to move.
You cannot resist.
Oh, nice. Nice, shooting wanted powers at me.
Neutralize Commander.
Well, I guess to be fair, we can do that too.
Our power is unmatched. Your form,
you can sometimes get like warps and throws to damn near do a 90 degree turn. Almost. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Not cool.
The forces of the universe bend to me.
He needs to go. He's down, right? Both my followers are down too. I could pick them up. Let me see if I can finish this off by myself. Just because. Samara's got this. She can hold it down, right?
Nothing stands against her.
Ah. Stupid barrier. Oh, nice.
My attacks will tear you apart.
Son of a bitch. Wow, how did that not kill him? Seriously. Got my health back. Take that. Got him again. Alright, it's just me and you, you big old bitch. You're gonna hang on to that last hit point, aren't you?
Nothing stands against us.
Seriously? What the f-
I know you feel this.
Wow. Alright.
I know when you're ready to move up, Commander.
Stubborn, man. Stubborn. Alright. This is probably a good save spot. I really don't want to do this again. Like I said, at some point I need to switch this to autosave also. Getting the point pretty soon where I won't be able to manually save. Like I said, I don't wanna have to repeat a bunch of this stuff if I make a mistake, or the game freezes, or whatever. This spot coming up right here is really nasty, if I remember. In fact, I think this is the hardest spot in this whole mission, right here. The one I have trouble with, anyway. Probably a good spot for a grenade launcher, actually.
Yeah!
Yeah! He kicked somebody's ass. Good to know they're doing their thing over there.
We've been spotted. I'll hold this position.
Yeah, when Samara warns you it's about to be a firefight, it's about to be a firefight.
Here we go.
Son of a bitch. The range on that. Maybe one more headshot. This is son of a bitch.
My shields are down.
What do you do? Deal with the Huss or deal with the... I'm getting big ugly. Really? Son of a bitch. Okay. Things are getting ugly now. How did that not kill him? Nice. Ooh, that was close, man. Still got a husk somewhere? Yeah. I'll deal with one. Take that. Hey, you like all that punch in the face stuff? Let's do it. Feeling like a badass now. Like I say, that's the one, it tends to kill me quick. Get hogged by the stupid husks who are beating you all in your face, and then get hit with the shockwave from the Scion at the same time, and yeah, it's over.
Moving up, Commander.
I actually had a really good run on this up until the very, very end, and I got into an ammo problem. You'll see when we get there. And finally got caught up, knocked out of cover and I think shot, you know, type of thing. And then, luckily had the autosave active by that time. And then, the end just made it look easy. It was weird, it gave me a restock of ammo. I'll show you when we get there. It was interesting. I guess if you die at the very, very end without ammo, the game, gives you a break. And doesn't reload your character with zero ammo or something. I don't know. You'll see. See when we get there. And other than that, it was a really smooth run.
Need to get there soon. We're leaving the barrier.
Oops. Oops. See ya.
We're leaving the barrier.
Shockwave is beautiful.
Hold on. We're almost there.
Shepard, I think if Samara's not loyal right here, then right here at the end, she either fades out and winds up getting killed, or she burns herself out. By letting out one last little gasp or something. I don't remember. But anyway. Boom. Take that. Yeah, she's a badass.
Shepard, do you copy?
I copy. What's your position? We're coming, just hold on! Get this door open! Come on!
Yeah, and this is... If your squad leader like Jacob isn't loyal, that's where he would die.
I'm okay. Just need a second to catch my breath.
That's right. You got that, man.
Joker, are you at the rendezvous point?
I'm here, Commander. Chakwas and the rest of the crew just showed up.
Garrus's group just arrived, Shepard. No casualties.
Excellent. Now let's make it count. Edie, what's our next step?
There should be some nearby platforms that will take you to the main control console. From there, you can overload the system and destroy the base.
Commander, you got a problem. Hostiles massing just outside the door. Won't be long till I bust through.
A rear guard could defend this position and keep the collectors from overwhelming us.
Pick a team to go with you, Shepard. Everyone else can bunker down here and cover your back.
Yeah, I think here, if you haven't lost anybody, you don't even have to decide who stays. So everyone stays. But I know Grunt and Zaid are good enough, just those two, to hold them off. They're two of the best defenders. I guess because they're considered the tankiest or something? I don't know. You know, I've never really used that. I think it comes as a DLC thing, and I'm not a fan of DLC items because I think they tend to be overpowered. You know, they're way too strong for the level you have access to them, that type of thing. I'm not a fan of that.
I'm ready, Commander.
Me too.
Anything to say before we do this?
The Collectors blindside their targets. Hit and run. As powerful as they are, they're cowards. They've never had to stand and fight the best of us.
That's you.
I don't know if they can feel fear, but we're damn sure gonna give them the opportunity. Hit them hard. one way or another, it ends here.
Grunt likes that.
Well said. Let's go finish this.
Alright, this is really reminiscent of the collective ship. And you fight wave after wave of these platforms. A little bit easier now, or a little bit stronger. I guess they are too, but no match for us, right? What? Okay, just forget I ever even did that. Wow. I can't light up a shot for shit. Here, take that. Get him? You got him. Oh man, what a waste. Okay. He's not really a threat if he's just gonna hide over there like a bitch. See ya. Okay, well, I'm not moving up. I'll stay right here. I'm a sniper. This is my job. Sit back here and dish out the pain from a distance. Got some nasty looking heads. Get him!
Nothing can stop me.
I dodged it, huh? There we go. Keep on coming. Every platform they drop puts more distance between me and them. I'm cool with that.
They're right ahead of us.
Yeah, I knew one of those guys was coming. How did he not die? Seriously. Okay, take that.
This is what you face.
I'll finish him off like this.
My favorite thing.
Got him. Get that dude. Oh, Miranda's down? Where'd she go down? Ooh. I think I hit him. Are they bringing two platforms at once? Looks like it.
I will direct this personally.
I think I hit him. Wow, she's got some range on that. Yeah, yep, range is definitely the way to go with Chocolate, definitely. Yeah, I don't even think the Scions have that kind of range. This easy. Might be a huge expenditure of ammo, though. How many shots it takes to kill this guy anyway? What's that stupid barrier he's got? How many rounds that give me? Like, two or three?
Taking cover!
Okay, we gotta deal with these guys right now.
Easy enough.
See ya. Nice. Two shots. these count. I don't know about that one. I don't think so. Go ahead and creep this way if you want to. I was talking to one of you guys about some of the creatures that the Reapers use. Like, the Husks are obviously human. And then, of course, the Collectors being old Protheans, they pretty much look the same, as far as I can tell. But, wondering about these Scions, if they're just a collection of several humans all kind of lumped together? Or maybe they're a result of some of the Krogan tissue that... Okir said specifically that he sent many, many Krogans to the... Collectors for whatever they were using it for, and so we know what they're we got an idea what they're collecting people for. I actually find out a little bit more about that later too, but I was wondering what maybe they used all those Krogan for. Maybe these Scions are a little bit of Krogan material mixed with human or something. Don't know. Another bullet on this thing. There we go. Is that it? That's it. Nice. Yeah, I don't believe in creeping forward as you fight them to just get mobbed. That doesn't make any sense. Just sit back here and chill. I notice I'm pretty low on most ammo, and that's going to go pretty quick, but, like right here, this is why I'm really glad I set up autosave.
This is it. All the tubes lead to this spot. Edie, what can you tell us? What are they doing?
The tubes are feeding into some kind of superstructure. It is emitting both organic and non-organic energy signatures. Given these readings, it must be massive. Shepard, if my calculations are correct, the superstructure is a Reaper.
Not just any Reaper. Human Reaper.
Precisely.
Collectors gain by turning humans into this Reaper shell.
They may be facilitating the Reaper equivalent of reproduction, or it may serve another purpose. I do not have the data to speculate further. However, it is clear that the Collectors are merely pawns. The technology and ability needed to create this Reaper is not their own. It is likely that different species construct each Reaper. In this case, the Collectors provide the labor.
The Collectors are just Protheans. Why would they help the Reapers?
The Reapers subdued the Protheans long ago. Probabilities suggest they attempted to create a Prothean Reaper and failed. Over time, they adapted the Protheans to suit their needs, changed them, turned them into workers, tools for the Reapers.
How many more humans do you think they'd try to take?
Millions. Perhaps more. Impossible to know for certain. This Reaper appears to be in a very early stage of development. An embryo in human terms.
So it's not alive yet. We can still stop it from being created?
The process can be stopped, but it is unclear exactly how much it has developed. I cannot, for example, tell you if it has awareness.
They're building it to look like a human. Why?
It appears that a Reaper's shape is based upon the species used to create it.
Reapers are machines. Why do they need humans at all?
Incorrect. Reapers are sapient constructs, a hybrid of organic and inorganic material. The exact construction methods are unclear, but it seems probable that the Reapers absorb the essence of a species, utilizing it in their reproduction process.
It's too big for our guns. Edie, Find me a way to blow this thing to hell.
The large tubes injecting the fluid are a weak structural link. Destroying them should cause the supports to collapse and the Reaper to fall.
Give us a minute, Edie. We gotta take care of some old friends.
All right.
Enemies incoming!
I guess there's a couple different ideas here. One is that perhaps this is being designed to replace Sovereign, who we destroyed at the Citadel. Because remember, Sovereign had an actual name, a proper name, Nazara, according to Legion. So it's possible that these are individuals. They consider themselves as much a people or a species as any organics do. Or, you know, even Legion, for that matter. He considers the Geth a people. So I'm wondering if the Reapers are trying to do that, or if this is actually, and this leans more towards my theory overall on the message of the entire game, is this is what the machines aspire to. This is what they want to be. They want to be organic, they want to be alive, they want to be living beings. Nice, got them both. Sweet, one more wave of these guys and we're gonna knock this bitch to the ground. And so maybe in humanity they found what they've been looking for over all the past cycles. Every 50,000 years they're waiting for that one species that they want to meld with or become one with to actually gain the one thing they can't ever have, which is life, you know, free will, ability to dream and hope and fear and love and hate and blah blah blah. They sure seem to hold a grudge, but it's like a mimicry of a grudge. They've only learned to boast and brag based on the studies they've done of the people who they've devoured before them. You know, it's a mimicry. It's a very advanced mimicry, developed over billions of years, but it's still a mimicry. It's not life. So they've used the universe and everything that's been in it. All the lives and the hopes and the dreams of sentient species, you know, humans and Protheans and all the species that have gone on before. Most that are extinct nowadays, right? They've devoured them all at the expense of trying to achieve their goal. Of course, machines wouldn't know boredom, right? They can spend billions of years trying to do what they're doing.
Ground team, status report.
It's safe. We are holding, but they keep coming. A quick exit is preferable.
Head to the Normandy! Joker, prep the engines. I'm about to overload this place and blow it sky high.
Roger that, Commander. Commander, I've got an incoming signal from the Elusive Man. He's patching it through.
Uh-huh. He just conveniently knew where we were. That we had arrived.
Shepard, you've done the impossible.
I'm not finished here yet. The space is 10 minutes from extinction.
Wait. I have a better option.
Uh-huh.
I'm looking at the schematics Edie uploaded. A timed radiation pulse would kill the remaining collectors, but leave the machinery and technology intact. This is our chance, Shepard. They were building a Reaper. That knowledge, that framework could save us.
No, sorry.
I came here to destroy it, but if you have another idea, I'm listening.
We've won a single victory, but we're still at war. This base will give us the technology we need to fight the Reapers.
Maybe it's for the best.
Seriously? Shepard, he's a user, just like collectors.
Yep.
Your crew needs to understand that billions of lives are at stake. Leadership means making sacrifices. You know that better than anyone, Shepard.
I'm gonna learn the lesson.
We'll fight and win without it. I won't let fear compromise who I am.
Yep.
Miranda, do not let Shepard destroy the base.
Or what? You'll replace me next?
I gave you an order, Miranda.
I noticed. Consider this my resignation.
Shepard, think about what's at stake, about everything Cerberus has done for you.
Surprise, bitch. Told you I'd get the last laugh. Ha ha! You cannot use anything Reaper for your own purposes. That is the mistake everyone's made in every cycle in the galaxy up to this point. We're gonna... That buck stops here. That pattern is over. Alright. Anyway, notice... Okay. It started me off with, like, no ammo. I mean, like, none. Zero. I had, like, one round and one gun and then a few missiles in my missile launcher. That was it. And I'm like, huh. Well, that didn't end well. And then when it restarted me here, I don't think I'm full, but I have some to work with. In fact, it even resupplies me with some ammo here. It's weird. Well, you'll see. But I thought that was interesting. Now, same fight. I mean, as far as that goes, nice to have something to shoot with. Yeah, it doesn't help that you've got these little minions running around, too, trying to shoot you. But you got this damn robot breathing his laser lips at you. Gotta get through that armor, man. He's got a really, really weak spot on his chest. It's like a heart. Yeah, you see that? It's hard to get a shot. Yeah, let's go ahead and hook up something else. Shit. This thing, she doesn't really have a range thing. She's up close and personal. That's the only downside to having Jack along in an infiltrator party, is where you want to stay at a distance. She has to get up in your face to really do a lot. Although Shockwave has some range, I don't think she's going to do anything with Shockwave here. But it doesn't matter. She brought us this far. I'll keep it along. I'll take this Reaper down by myself if I have to. Yeah, it's awkward trying to get a shot on the heart. Easier with slow time, with the sniper slow time. He's fixing to knock one of the platforms down, I think. About a quarter of the way or so. It's going pretty good. I get a shot on his heart with my missile launcher. Don't think that hit. Yeah, you might want to stay down for that. This son of a bitch. Might as well spin these now, right? That's about all it's good for. And he's gonna knock me out. I believe that's what killed me the first time. Yeah, right there. He knocks you out while a couple other collectors are shooting at you, and it's over, like, really fast. I hit those, and they didn't do shit. I didn't do more damage with my sniper, honestly. Get out of here. You're ugly, and I didn't want to look at you anyway. I really hope you guys have enjoyed this. I know a lot of you have stayed true to the series, going all the way back to the first game. And I hope you continue on to the third one, because I did kind of hint that it's probably... I like all three equivalently. I'm not going to say it's any more or less fun or whatever. It's the build that I use for Mass Effect 3 is a lot of fun to me. It's probably the most fun I have of any of the class builds in any of the three games. I can say that. But I hope you guys stay for that. There's a lot of feels in Mass Effect 3, especially at the end. Especially at the end. But it brings a lot of good closure to the game. I guess he knocked me off my platform. And see, I got some ammo for that. That's something I didn't do the first fight anyway. But it's almost over now. It doesn't really matter. What we don't need is any, collectors coming up to surprise us. This is done with sending minions after us. Now it's just a matter of whittling this guy down. Ouch, ouch. Oh, I take that back. I was wrong. Get him, Jack. Get him. Hit him with that shockwave. Okay, I don't think that hit anybody. I'll take that! I actually wanted two more shots. I don't even have to worry about all these collectors.
Now let's finish you off.
That's right. We can finish him off now. There you go. See ya. Where's this damn robot? Whoa. All right. Surprise. One more shot. One more shot. No, no. No. Reload. Got him. Get down, you big old bitch. Put an end to this. Got to one-up the elusive man. He just thought he had it all mapped out. We were just going to be a tool in his little toolbox and do exactly what we were assigned to do and all this and that and help him destroy humanity in the name of humanity. You know what he would do with this kind of technology? Well, you know what? He's going to get his hands on it anyway. I'd strongly considered giving it to him regardless because my reasoning would have been, just to let you know ahead of time, had I gone the other way, my reasoning would have been this, is that people would have died for him to get his hands on this technology anyway, because he's not going to be denied. But, you know, an opportunity to stick it in his face and just tell him to go blow the big one, I couldn't pass that up. Like I said, I think he's going to get this regardless, and I think people will die in the process, whether he has to send people through the Omega-4 relay over and over until he finally gets his hands on this junk, you know, whatever it takes. I don't know, maybe he's got onboard stuff on the Normandy that helped him plot a course when we came in so that he can send in people at, you know, he's got a backup plan. But so I couldn't give him what he wanted.
I'm here, Joker. Did the ground team make it?
All survivors on board, we're just waiting for you.
That's what I'm talking about. Leave no one behind.
You know as Reapers are your salvation from destruction.
That's the message they tell the indoctrinated. Submit and it'll go well for you. This is the best thing for you. Even Joker out there with the machine gun. That's right. Give it to him. They pissed Joker off when they damn near took his ship again and took his crew. Love Joker, man. Dude's cool. Can I get a little help here? Just saying. That's right, Miranda. We became friends. She saw the light. She was down for the truth when it counted. She may have been a little naive in a lot of spots up to this point, but when it mattered, she came through, along with the rest of the crew. The elusive man didn't see that coming. There's so much to manipulate to guarantee an outcome of his choosing that it's nice to see the look on its face when things don't go his way. This is where I almost feel sorry for this bug. He had no will of his own. He's just a tool. But you know what? That's mercy. That's grace right there, if nothing else. Put an end to it. They've been extinct for a long time. They've been genetically modified. Those aren't Protheans anymore. You release them and it's a shell. You know, it's that. But it was sad. I actually was a little sad right there. I'm like, wow. They may be ugly, but still, no living beings deserve that. It's nice to see him released from that.
Shepard, you're making a habit of costing me more than time and money.
Haha.
Sorry, I'm having trouble hearing you. Getting a lot of bullshit on this line.
Don't try my patience. The technology from that base could have secured human dominance in the galaxy. Against the Reapers and beyond.
Uh-huh.
Human dominance, or just Cerberus?
Strength for Cerberus is strength for every human.
No.
Cerberus is humanity.
No.
I should have known you'd choke on the hard decisions. Too idealistic from the start.
Oh, go blow it.
I know what you are and the price of dealing with you. We do things my way from now on. Harbinger is coming and he won't be alone. I'm gonna make sure we're ready when they get here. You can fall in line or step aside, but don't get in my way.
You're sure that's what you want? You're taking a hell of a risk, Shepard.
Stay in check, bitch.
Joker, lose this channel.
Since I don't have a council to hang up on. I'm taking your shit too, bitch. That investment didn't pay off, did it? Like I say, we haven't done a whole lot. Notice that planet is blue now. Had we given him that, it would be red. That was supposed to be the Paragon choice. I said I don't think it matters in the long run either way, but at least we made things a little harder on him. And it was a personal snub that he definitely had coming. All right, so I'm going to leave you guys with some closing dialogue with some of the squad mates in case you've become attached to any of them, like I have. Went and talked to everybody now that this is over. And then, I don't know, maybe make a trip to go see my girlfriend, Liara. I've earned it, right? But when I meet up with you guys again, we will be in Mass Effect 3. Hope you guys are there. And I look forward to a lot of fun with that one. I think, well, let's just put it this way. If you got a really loud stereo and a lot of really, really hardcore death metal to play, that goes really well with Shepard in Mass Effect 3, the way I like to play her, because it's anger time, it's rage time. If you think my Shepard is one that you wouldn't want to cross up to this point, when you get into Mass Effect 3, it's really no bullshit. She's really not trying to hear it, because it's been personal up to this point, but it gets really, really personal, and we'll see why. It's amazing what they've done with this game. You hear me say that a lot, because I can't overstate that. Got our full ship collection and everything else. Very cool. I wonder if anyone's... Nope, no new messages. Lucid Man doesn't have anything to say about that, does he? Uh-huh. We win. Alright, people. I'm gonna go talk to some folks. Hope you enjoyed that, and when I see you again, we'll be in Mass Effect 3. Y'all take care.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal. You came for us. I knew you would. Thank you. 1,000 times, thank you.
How are you doing, Kelly?
I'm holding up. Can't get the memories out of my head. Trapped. Suffocating. It's oozing into every pore. Faint sobs echoing the confined space. But I can't dwell on it. I'm okay now. I'm alive. Back to the old Kelly.
Is there anything I should know?
Nothing right now. Anything else, Commander?
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later.
I told you we'd tear the collectors a new one.
Yeah, Commander really pulled through.
Hey, Shepard, glad that collector Reaper crap is over. It is over, right? It's never over.
Ever think about the old Normandy and the trouble we got up to?
Yeah, those seem like the good old days now, but come on, it was hell at the time. Geth, Saren, Sovereign, and then we got dumped. We're stuck in a weird place, sure, but back then it wasn't all sunshine and bunnies.
I assume everything's going well up here?
You know, this is really nice. Edie took up the slack in every department. I could get used to this kind of help.
It is not my intention to assume all of your responsibilities, Jeff.
No, I'm good. Just keep me updated. Quietly.
What am I looking at here? A 90-10 split? And that's being generous.
Commander, don't be unfair. She does way more than that.
Joker.
I have the capacity to accommodate the slacking of any number of productively suspect humans, Shepard. That was a joke.
She tries very hard.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
didn't expect you to light up that base, Shepard. Hell of a way to tell the boss you're quitting. I wish I could have seen his face. It's not over, though. Bad guys on the horizon. And now Cerberus wants your tail. Never boring, huh? I don't know what kind of time we have, but we better dust off and stay ready. You sure as hell know how to make enemies.
I understand you made quite an impact after you left the Alliance.
Like I said, it was where I met Miranda and got scouted by Cerberus. It took us out to the Nemean Abyss and back. Saved the Citadel from a Batarian bioweapon. The whole thing was hushed, like they're good at doing. But I know what I did, and I'm proud of it.
We'll talk later.
Commander.
Collectors destroyed, base in ruins. Extremely impressive. Elusive man will be displeased. Fortunately, not human myself. Not my problem.
Any ideas on other ways to prepare for the collectors?
Sorry, I've done what I can. Focusing on studying collector tech now.
Have you got a minute to talk?
Not a good time. Trying to map contamination vectors requires focus. Shipwide infection of human-tailored virus possible if I slip. Anything else?
I'll let you work.
We'll be here if you need me.
I wanted to tell you, I believe you did the right thing by destroying that base. The elusive man thinks he has the wisdom to utilize it, but he does not.
Anything new?
There is something I've wanted to tell you. I've done many things in my lifetime. I thought the galaxy held nothing new for me. Since joining you, I've realized how much more there is.
You must have seen many things in your years of travel.
As a maiden, I served as a mercenary. I fought tyrants and pirates. I experienced everything the galaxy has to offer. As a Justicar, I saw parts of Asari space few know about. I destroyed villages and saved cities. I even fought a Spectre.
What was being a mercenary like?
I was a young, impulsive maiden who discovered her talent for combat. I reveled in it, until the day my troop was hired to guard a mysterious shipment on its way to some clandestine drop-off area. I discovered the shipment was slaves, to be traded to the collectors for advanced technology.
I can't imagine you went along.
I demanded that we turn around. My mates disagreed. After they were dead, I brought the ship around. The collector craft was just arriving. They closed faster than I could flee. Fortunately, we were close to the mass relay. I got through, and they did not pursue.
What did you do with all the slaves?
I lectured them on the virtues of strength and defending oneself. Then I distributed the armor, weapons, and credits of my dead colleagues, and released the captives on the Citadel.
Why would you destroy an entire village?
I tracked Morinth to a remote colony world. She'd perverted an entire town, making them worship her and bring young Asari as sacrifices. When I arrived, she fled, throwing her minions at me in waves. They bought her time with their lives. When it was done, only small children remained. I left them in the authorities' care and continued my pursuit.
Why did you fight a Spectre?
A Turian named Nihilus. He may have been on Council business, but I witnessed him kill an unarmed civilian. Following the code, I attacked.
Nihilus seemed like an honorable Turian, and a good Spectre.
He may have been. However, killing unarmed civilians is wrong.
How did the fight turn out?
I had the advantage, but he was good. He returned fire and tried to run. We played cat and mouse in the wilderness for 2 weeks. It was exhilarating. Finally, he created a situation in which my only options were to let an innocent die or pursue him. The code compelled me to save the innocent, and he escaped. I admire how he adapted and used my code against me.
What have your years as a Justicar been like?
Mostly tedium and hardship. Traveling on freighters, wandering through rural areas, rooting out injustices, big and small, putting down corrupt officials, When I arrive in a remote area, individuals often approach me with matters of justice. My judgment rarely turns out the way they hope.
How do you pay for transportation between worlds?
Asari captains often welcome Justicars. We reduce pirate attacks. One raid was called off when the pirates were able to verify that I was aboard.
We're not done with this yet.
I am sure. It will be my honor to be by your side at the end.
I should go.
Of course. The fight continues.
You had to make a difficult choice, Shepard. For what it's worth, I believe you made the correct one.
Have a few minutes to talk?
Very well. I had been recording a message for Kolyat.
How are things going with him?
It is difficult. All things worth keeping are. I never explained. I suppose the story of my wife's death took you by surprise.
As a rule, I'm not fond of surprises.
I didn't think it would be relevant. I expected to die without speaking to Kolyat again. I knew he'd blame me for Erika's death. That memory I mentioned before. Laser dot trembles on the target's skull. The smell of spice on a spring wind. Sunset eyes defiant in the scope. That was Erika. That was how I met her. She saw my targeting laser as she walked by and threw herself in the way.
So how'd she go from blocking your shot to having your children?
I had to meet her. The memory possessed and endowed me. I fell on my knees before her, begged her pardon. She introduced me to the world beyond my work. Eventually, she forgave me. Later, she loved me.
I guess she impressed you.
She woke me up. Her body trembles, not fear. Indignation. Her mouth moves. How dare you? You and I trained to sacrifice ourselves to save others. How often does a civilian step in the way of a bullet to protect someone they've never met? I thought she was the goddess Urashu. She met my eyes through the scope, and my purpose faltered.
When you talked to Kolyat, you said she died.
I let myself become complacent. I thought Erika and Kolyat were safe. I stayed away too long, and my enemies came for her.
Who came for her?
Batarians, a slaver ring that was preying on Hanar outer colonies. I'd killed their leaders. They paid the Shadow Broker to find out who I was. But they were afraid of me, so they went after her.
You told Kolyat that you hunted her killers down.
Erika woke me up. When she passed, I returned to my battle sleep. My body hunted her killers, murdered them. I was taught to grant death quickly, cleanly, to minimize suffering. Them. I let them linger.
I don't blame you. They killed innocents to get to you.
For you and me, death is business. For people like them, it is sport. I haven't spoken about my wife, and I don't think I ever have. I didn't have anyone left to tell it to.
You're talking to your son again. That's huge. Don't lose sight of that by dwelling on should-have-beens.
You are correct, of course. Thank you for listening, Siha.
I think my translator just glitched. What did you call me?
Siha. Someday I'll tell you what it means.
People are talking out there, and I hear it all. Joker and Edie are like an old married couple. I keep expecting to walk in on them bickering about the temperature in the cockpit.
We had to do it, Shepard. Taking down the Collector base was the right decision. The Elusive Man might not agree, but we had no choice.
Do you have a minute, Miranda?
There's a lot to do, Shepard. Maybe another time.
I'll let you work.
Of course, Commander.
I can't believe you took down the collectors. I'm proud to serve under you, Commander. Hawthorne is still in the infirmary, though I think his pride is more broken than his bones. He tried so hard to help Joker.
You really are a hero. No sooner had the collectors damned us than you were pulling our sorry asses right back out of hell. You're aces in my book, Shepard. Thank you.
For Sarah, now the collectors. Remind me never to get on your bad side, Shepard. I almost feel sorry for the Reapers.
Have you got a minute?
Sure, just killing time anyway. Optimizing weapons charges, planning attack vectors, you know, relaxing. I'm still trying to figure out how to prepare for this mission. Humans don't deal with stress the way Turians do.
Thanks for the talk, Garrus. I'll see you later.
Sure thing.
Shepard Commander, your species was offered everything Geth aspired to. True unity, understanding, transcendence. You rejected it. You even refused the possibility of using the old machine's gifts to achieve it on your species' own terms. You are more like us than we thought.
I'd like to find out more about you.
Topic.
When we took you aboard, I noticed you have a piece of N7 armor welded to you. Where'd you get it?
It was yours. When you disappeared, we were sent to find you. We began where you first encountered the heretics.
Eden Prime.
After the old machine's attack, it was heavily defended. We were discovered. This is the impact of a rifle shot.
How many other Geth were sent out to find me?
We are the only mobile platform beyond the Veil. Organics fear us. We wish to understand, not incite. One platform was judged sufficient.
You've been looking for me for 2 years?
We visited Therum, Theros, Novaria, Vermeer, Ilos. A dozen unsettled worlds. The trail ended at Normandy's wreckage. You were not there. Organic transmissions claimed your death. We recovered this debris from your hard suit.
The Geth are listening in on our transmissions?
Organic life reacts to stimuli in unpredictable ways. We wish to learn.
Sounds like you're running experiments on us.
You are sapient life, but not like us. If we can model organic behavior, we can comprehend the Quarian creators. We do not understand their judgments in the Morning War.
What's the Morning War?
The conflict between the Geth and the Quarian creators. The war fought at the dawn of our intelligence. It concluded with the departure of the Creator Migrant Fleet.
Why were you trying to contact me?
You opposed the heretics, those that took the old machines as gods.
All kinds of organics fought Sovereign and his Geth allies. Why am I so interesting?
You were the most successful. You killed their god. You succeeded where others did not. Your code is superior.
That doesn't explain why you used my armor to fix yourself.
There was a hole.
But why didn't you fix it sooner, or with something else?
No data available.
I'm still a little shaken from my abduction by the collectors. It was a lot to endure. You and Jeff came so quickly. I've never had truer friends. Thank you, Commander.
Back for more? Joker handled himself well.
Should have come back here and got a real weapon. Still, did real well for a kid with glass palms. Pretty sure I'd be laid up in bed if I were him. I used to do a little scorched earth work here and there. Then the Batarians started muscling in. No one's as good with terror tactics as they are. I mean, the Krogans will come at you, break your face, kill your family. But the Batarians, they'll turn your planet into a glass parking lot without a second thought. I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard.
I can't believe we destroyed the collector base. They said it couldn't be done. Then again, that's said about a lot of things you do.
Have you got time to talk?
I really need to clean up this engine. Maybe later?
I'll let you work.
Talk to you later.
I've got green across the board. The forward tanks are buoyant and elevated.
Are you talking about the Normandy or Miranda?
I'm talking about the one that's covered and protected, not bouncing in the breeze.
I don't know. Operative Lawson's uniform is very official. It always makes me stand at attention.
You're such a dog.
Thanks for coming to get us, Commander.
I felt myself slipping away. You arrived just in time. Thank you.
Carry on.
Will do, Commander.
Hey.
What's happening?
Shepard, we talked enough. You're just pissing around. No hard feelings, but I don't want to play.
I should go.
Whatever.
Shepard, and when you blew up the base instead of handing it to Cerberus, something to think about. If you killed the most dangerous thing in the galaxy, that leaves us.
Just checking in. How are you doing?
I'm branching out. Got a list of enemies now. They all give me joy when I picture cutting them, crushing them. There's this one imprint, a Solarian with a... what are they? The things on his head pulled apart? Bet it caused a generation of revenge. What is that, a few weeks for them? So what did you want?
Don't wear yourself out on someone else's memories. We've got our own bad guys to fight.
Your enemies are my enemies. We'll shove the Collector's claws where a dark sun can't shine. And they will deserve it. I won't disrespect their strength by doing less than the worst to them.
That's the kind of thinking that will save a galaxy.
You make it possible, Shepard. You're my battlemaster. You give me purpose. That's what makes Krogan feared soldiers and not animals. Lead well, Shepard. You have my respect.
Thanks for watching. If you want to subscribe, if you haven't already, click that button up top. For the entire playthrough of Mass Effect 1, click the top box. For the rest of this Let's Play, up to this point, click the bottom box. Appreciate you watching. Remember to leave a like and a share, or somebody else who might get into this type of thing. Alright, y'all take care, and I'll catch you on the next one. Bye-bye.